Hi and welcome back to my channel. And if you're new, hi and welcome to my channel. I'm doing the rising sign readings for the month ahead, what's left the month of November. It's not as late as last month, at least anyway. But so this is for the rising sign of Scorpio. And if you haven't seen these before, I usually like to talk about the astrological things going on at the moment in the skies, because often I feel that certain things sort of play into your readings. So anyway, let's get on to it, and I'll try and be quick so I'm not my usual long drawn out self. But so you would have already known by now that Venus and Mercury, who were in retrograde, are completely out of their retrogrades, completely out of their post-shadows. Everything's fine with them. They're completely direct. Pluto went into stationing direct on the 11th of October. So a lot of people will say, oh, Pluto's direct now. Well, yes, but he's in his post-shadow. And my guess is the majority of the rest of this year he's going to be in post shadow, because he's pretty much the slowest mover, 248 years to get to the same spot in the zodiac. So yeah, from, you know, to travel from and back to. So anyway, and then Saturn, by the time you see this, by the time I've got this uploaded, Saturn would have already also stationed direct, moving into his post shadow. And he'll be 1 to 2 months, my guess is. So I think that he'll be completely direct before the end of the year, though. And Neptune will be stationing direct on the 6th of December. Again, post-shadow phase will start from then. Chiron will be direct on the 27th of December. Jupiter will be stationing direct on the 31st of December. Uranus won't be until the 27th of January next year in 2024. I want to try and still do a video for Jupiter retrograde, even though he's already in retrograde and we've already passed the pre-shadow. I still wanted to do a video for Jupiter retrograde like I did with Venus and put it on the community tab. It's not going to be a card reading. It's going to be with the charts and rising sign information and stuff, you know, ways to work with it according to your rising sign and so forth, things that would come up and all that business that might come up. So I wanted to knuckle down and do that. I've been sort of a bit preoccupied with some things that I feel have been taking me away from what I really want to do, which is this and, you know, my channel, you know, working on my channel instead. So I've had to sort of make some tough decisions recently so I could, you know, free up my time better. So yeah, that's me working with the eclipses. So having spoken about all the planets and their activities, retrograde and post shadows and all that, the eclipses happened last month, yes, but there's always at least a 3-month window either side where it's the lead up to the eclipse, then the eclipse, and then a three-month window on the other side of it. So technically it's 3 to 6 months, but definitely 3 months either side of the actual event of the eclipses. And I often think, considering both the eclipses were only 2 weeks apart and yet they've got 3-month windows on either side, there might be an amalgamation of endings and beginnings together in a sense, depending on what's going on with you, because there could be the focus on endings or the focus on beginnings as well, or it could be an amalgamation of both. So we're still in the eclipse doorway. So if we're looking at 3 months for instance, and the eclipses happened last month, we'll be looking in like halfway through January at least before the energies will taper off and be less intense, I guess. So I think that I've covered everything now. I don't think there's anything I've forgotten to mention. Oh yeah, I keep forgetting. I forgot to mention it with the last video as well. Mercury's going to be retrograding in December, I think the 13th of December. So the reason I say that, obviously it's November now, but the reason I'm saying it now is that there'll be, like I said, with the shadow phases, there's the pre-shadow and then the post-shadow of any retrograde. So the pre-shadow will dip into the last part of November as well. So we're talking probably 28th, 29th, 30th maybe, depending on where you're from, like, you know, geographically. So around about the 28th is when we'll start to feel the retrograde energies of Mercury again, and he'll be retrograding in sidereal Sagittarius. So yeah, so keep an eye out for that too. So okay, now we've said everything, I think. We'll jump into your reading, Scorpio Rises. Let's see what... Whoa! Well, this is good. This is good because this is the new moon energy. So big beginnings, bam. Hitting it out of the park. Yay. Oh, full moon. Now, look, this isn't the eclipse one, though. So this is just a regular full moon, which is probably going to be in the second half of the month, I think. Yeah, I think that's it. So it's not as powerful as that guy. So it's probably saying if there's anything, any changes, tweaks, changes, endings, like I was talking about, that need to be changed, that isn't really intense. You know, you can make those changes and then bring in the new that you want with this powerful eclipse energy. Scorpio, your rising sign, so how the world sees you, you know, the first thing that people see of you, your rising sign. Ninth house. Ooh, that's Sagittarius. I mentioned Sagittarius with Merc retro. Now, again, see, this is a thing. Mercury retrograde gets a bad rap that, oh, everything's just going to go crazy and blah, blah, sorry. But there's so much you can get from working with Mercury retrograde, that you can make the changes you need to make. You can work on whatever needs to be worked on. Or it might not necessarily be something that needs to be worked on, but it might be more about get into bringing in the new. What are your dreams, you know, bringing in your dreams? Because this ninth house is Sag themes, right? Growth and expansion, travel, philosophy, higher learning, Jupiter ruled. Jupiter's in retrograde. Still, the retrogrades don't mean that you won't have that energy as if it was direct. You still have those energies. It's not working against you. In fact, the retrogrades and the eclipses come about to help us, propel us forward, to bring in any changes needing to be made. And, you know, big, powerful energy that wants to come through for you. Powerful, good change for the better. What's your ninth house? What's in your ninth? Cancer, yeah. The fire Sag themes covered by the sign of Cancer, Cancerian. Home and family, nurturing, nurturance. Scorpio again, okay, your rising sign. This energy is intense, masterful, thoughtful, and magnetically charming, but also secretive and possessive. Well, if there's any negatives of that, clear that so you can bring in the new that you actually want. Libra. We're talking relationships, okay, seventh house themes, but this isn't in your seventh house, it's in your 12th, isn't it? I think it's your 12th. Yeah, because you're Scorpio rising, yeah. This energy is diplomatic and gracious. It seeks harmony and balance in relationships. So the relationship sign is in the Pisces themed 12th house for you. So there might be some sort of relationship with spirituality, or bringing romance through with art and spirituality. See, ninth house is also covering spirituality. 12th and ninth cover spirituality. Interesting. Did I read that? The energy is diplomatic and gracious. It seeks harmony and balance in relationships. Yeah. Seventh house, Libra themes. This area of your life is about long-term significant partners, romantic, business or family. I would also include friendships in that because it's relationships of all kinds. Now, that's your descendant. The seventh house is your descendant, which is Taurus, which is the sign of money and self-worth. So something to do with relationships, bring in the self-worth so you're not having that intense thing coming through. The moon, Cancer sign, is ruled by the moon. The ruling planet is the moon for Cancer, Cancerian sign, which happens to cover your ninth. Your unconscious, sensitive inner emotions and responses. So home and family with travel, like long distance travel, higher learning, expansion, growth, philosophy, spirituality, to a degree religion could be involved, maybe not. But there's definitely whatever, anything that needs any changes or different things that need to be manoeuvred into place. I don't feel it's, even though that's looking like it's intense, I don't feel this is the intense energy. I feel this one is, in a good way, intense, because it's saying, bring in the new. Opposition, balance. Well, there we have the Libra house and the Libra sign. So there's this need for balance. So we've got Scorpio, Libra, and Cancer are the main signs here so far. That's an aspect in the chart. You'll always find the aspects in the middle there that link up like different planets and nodes and whatnot. And asteroids, if you get your chart generated with asteroids in it too. The aspects will show what's connecting what. And opposition can be a difficult one. But also, here's the thing. Again, see, because, you know how I said that was your descendant, your seventh house is your descendant, which is Taurus, right? So you've got, you'll pretend this is your chart, right? And on this side, far left, you'll have your ascendant, and then far right, you'll have your descendant, and obviously they're in opposition because they're lining up exactly one to the other on the other, on each side of the chart, right? And through our lives, no matter what signs we are, we're needing to balance those opposites. And you'll always see pretty much every chart that you, wherever you go, that you get generated, will always say MC at the top. Some do and some don't say IC at the bottom. What you've got here is MC around about the ninth or tenth house. MC is your midheaven, and it's your working life, your career life, and right lining up exactly on the other side is IC, your home life, fourth house Cancerian themes, and that will line up exactly depending on where the MC is. Third or fourth house will be your IC, and again the balance of work and home life. So it's not necessarily a difficult thing. It can be difficult, you know. It's like with the retrogrades and the eclipses. They can be difficult if we're not working with them and even worse, if we're digging our heels in or our nails in, whatever, and refusing to work with them, refusing to budge, then it's difficult. But if we know, rightio, we have to balance these opposite energies, you know, then it becomes easier, and it's not such a pain, you know, it's not going to be so difficult for us. And again, I don't see the difficultness. I don't think that's a word. But yeah, even with that full moon here, I don't think it's going to be difficult for you to make any little changes and whatever that need to be done so that you can jump into that powerful new moon energy and bring in the new. Cancer, the doula. We've got Cancer again. So these signs are particularly prominent for you for some reason. One of them might be your sun sign. Libra or Cancer, or you might have double Scorpio. What else have we got? Jupiter, expansion. See, what was I saying? Expansion and growth with the ninth house. Jupiter rules Sag in the ninth house. So yes, expansion and growth. See, this is where this is going. The numinous, well, that's, you know, spirituality and ESP, I think, actually. Because I think I was saying how Pisces, why did I mention Pisces? No. Yeah, Pisces. For some reason I'm mentioning Pisces and I don't know why. Libra is the 12th house. I was looking for Pisces, couldn't find it, and couldn't find 12th house. Yeah, Libra's in Pisces, that's why. Yeah. I left out you guys because I was saying how Libra and Sag have the spirituality. You do too. You know, the occult, the esoteric, the ESP, the psychic ability, that sort of thing. Numinous, mystery, and that covers that. And you've got, the three water signs, yours, obviously, being your rising sign. Then we've got Pisces coming through and Cancer. Yeah. Quincunx, complexity. Okay, so there's, complicates, contradicts, puzzles, mystifies, mystery, numinous. You know, it can be a bit complicated to try and find that balance. Okay, so that's also an aspect, the quincunx. Let's see what else comes through though, because so far with everything else except for this one, I'm getting that this is easy energy or relatively easy. Ascendant, your rising sign, outlook, how the world sees you, first port of call. Scorpio again, dang. Okay, the animal, dare to be different, Scorpio, Scorpio, Scorpio. Virgo, okay, the alchemist. Be the doula and the animal, alchemize this ability, your abilities, and expand on them. I think that's what, and balancing these energies, that's, I think, sort of reiterating what I was saying earlier about the idea that both the eclipses were so close together, because they're always going to be 2 weeks apart anyway, full and new moon eclipse, right? So in that sense, there could be that sort of complexity with the energies and the balance. But see here, this is a regular full moon card. It's not the eclipse card, see? This one is, and this one's bringing in the new. So this is the one, it was the first card in the whole reading, see? So it was jumping out of the gate saying, bring in the new. That's the thing to focus on. Whatever this new is for you, that has something to do with psychic abilities, I think. Alchemize that and balance these energies so that you can work with that, bringing in the new. And um, Because your descendant is Taurus, money and self-worth. And Libra's in your 12th. So there might be some sort of relating to others to balance that. And that might be the complexity in that sense, because there's that family feel to it, but there's also the expansion and growth. So there might be, you might work with others perhaps in some way to bring this about. Whatever this is for you guys. Okay, these may or may not have reversals, and we'll go through it if there is. 11th house community, bam. It's the first time we've seen Aquarian energy, I think, because that's 11th house is Aquarius themes, and that is in, oh, that's in Virgo. Ah, wow. Okay. 11th house is in Virgo. 12th is Libra, and your first, obviously, is your rising sign, Scorpio. Yeah. So, yeah, relating to others in the community, bringing through, expanding on the ESP. Then maybe you have some kind of group where you help others, or everyone sort of helps each other with their psychic abilities in some way, maybe. That'd be cool. You know, alchemizing it, balancing, you know, this, it's complex because there's many relationships, many people involved in the community. Community generally has more than two people in it. So yeah. But this is all, I'm getting good vibes from this. So let's see what else. Neptune. Well, Neptune is still in retrograde. This is what I'm getting from this, not negative. Bring about your vision. I feel the only negative to this is that perhaps you haven't done it yet. So bring your vision to life. Work with the community. Bring your vision to life that, you know, connects everyone together, you know, and that's the complexity. Because Neptune is still in retrograde until December, right? Early December, 6th of December. And then he's in post shadow, so he's still going to have his energies still going. And again, don't fear the retrogrades, because they're here. In fact, they are here to nudge us to improve certain circumstances so we can have a better quality of life. Okay, what's this one? Pluto rebirth. Again, in retrograde. Well, actually, he's stationed direct, but he's in his post shadow. And I think this is perhaps you're already going through it, like you're starting to make the moves already in some way. Just needs a bit more tweaking and changing, a bit of a balance of other people's, you know, talents and skills with yours. And like I said, he's stationed direct, so he's still in his post-shadow phase. So he's technically still in the retrograde energies, in a sense, you could say, until he comes out of that and then he's direct again. But see, I think that's what it's reiterating. I think that you're, I think that this has already started, and it's just reiterating to work, to keep working with it, because I think it's not necessarily that you need a rebirth. I think this is more about you helping others to have a rebirth by allowing them to expand and grow and showing them the way. How cool is that? Yay. Okay, so let's see what your numerology says for you for November. What's your numerology? Do you want that one? Numerology for November. Get any other cards? Really? Okay, cool. do we have here? It's only one. Self-love. Wow. Yes. Boom. What was I saying with the Taurus money and self-worth thing? Because that's your descendant. Yeah, that's you. Because I was looking for Taurus and I was like, where did Taurus come through? I keep forgetting. Taurus, your descendant, money and self-worth. Balancing, see, it's a bit of a complex thing to balance the money and self-worth with your rising sign. Doesn't matter what sign we are, you know. Balancing of the opposites. So have that self-love as well, because it's going to take you quite a way, actually. Dare to be the animal, dare to be the doula in this. You have the power to alchemize these energies and get whatever going in that group that's going to help them to have their rebirth. Because I feel like you may have already had your own, so you can show them the way, kind of thing. Okay, so we've got this is sort of burnt orange, which gives me base and sacral chakra and energy. So it's still sort of the self-worth idea to me. This is about communicating, throat chakra. So you've got your blue of Neptune anyway, blue Libra, and your community. See, communicating in your community. Six is temporary opportunity. Doesn't mean you won't get another one. Just means it's here now. So grab hold of it and take it by the reins, you know. One is emotional vitality and personal power. See, self-love, personal power, money and self-worth in your seventh house, the Taurus. And then six and one is seven, the mind and creativity. Bring that creativity, expand on it. I mean, you didn't get Leo, but yeah, I'm getting creativity in that sense with the expansion, growth sort of thing. Because fifth house for you is in Pisces, but Pisces came through as a 12th house, not Neptune is the ruling planet of Pisces. Where's Leo? Leo's in your 10th. 10th didn't come through. I think this is definitely a community thing, and you can help others to have a rebirth and find self-worth for themselves as well by you loving yourself and daring to jump into these energies, the doula and the animal, you know, and just, yeah, I think that you're going to show whatever community you have the way, whatever that way is. You're going to, and it's going to be empowering for them and you by showing yourself love as well. What else can I say? Definitely your rising sign is really coming through pretty strong. So how people will see you is in a good light. So you don't need to worry about whatever this is. Go for it, because remember, we hit it up with the new moon energy. That's the one that's more in focus than the full moon. So yes, any tweaks and changes, but you don't have to stress about it. It's nothing dramatic or big, you know, and intense. So these will be messages for your abundance for November. Really? Okay, cool. Okay, we're done. Well, you've got a few, because you've got like one card with the other. Okay, yeah, you're done. Hopefully this is making sense. I'm not sure if I'm making sense here, but yeah. I don't think it's you that needs this rebirth. I think it's others that will, by what you do and what you share, they'll have a rebirth in a good way. You know, you'll be able to empower yourself and others. Okay, so we've got this one. I said yes when you first thought of it, now when you first asked, and hallelujah, so be it, coming right up when you first gave thanks in advance, believing in you, the universe. Yeah, the universe knows you've got this, so you believe in you. Now, are these, no, this is this way. These don't have reversals, so don't worry, yeah. Okay, I'm sorry, but concerning your dream job, did you want a salary, royalties, commission, or all three? How many weeks vacation are you expecting? Are you willing to share the New York apartment? Oh, and should your London assistant speak French, or will your French be sufficient by then? Helps to be really clear. N'est-ce pas? The universe, yep. So focus on what it is you want to expand, grow, bring into the community, clear up anything or make any tweaks, changes, work on whatever, you know, the final touches even or something like that. Full moon doesn't necessarily mean you're getting rid of things that are upsetting you. Yes, we do that too. But it can sometimes just simply mean we have to just finalize certain things so that we can then move forward with the new moon energy. Here's what I ask folks who aspire to being fabulously rich. Couldn't you just pretend you're a multi-millionaire, you know, right after you're done pretending you're not? It's all pretend, the universe. Exactly. You can bring about whatever damn well you like, Scorpio. You have it within you. The universe believes in you. You've got the expansion and growth of Jupiter and the ninth wanting to support you. You can bring your vision to fruition. Absolutely. Let the status symbols you seek most be self-made adventures that excite you at dawn, challenge you by day, and surprise you by night. Self-made being the operative word. Creatorhood rocks. Creator. Maybe you'll have some sort of channel, like a YouTube channel or a group. Even on YouTube, even with YouTube, you don't have particular groups, but through the comments section or on the lives, that's where you can get your communities moving, you know? Everyone can interact as a community, if that makes sense. So either Facebook or, I don't know about the other ones, I'm not on them. So Facebook, YouTube, that's what I know. I don't know the others. So you might be on other platforms where you can, yeah. So jump into that if you haven't already, because the rebirth isn't going to be just for you if you are needing a rebirth, but I feel like you're already in the energy, like as in you're not needing a rebirth because it's already happening and others will have one as well, you know, once you share what it is that you offer, because it's needed. The best thing about every financial meltdown, global or otherwise, is learning that whatever was lost can be recreated, exceeded, and made better than it was before. Hold on loosely, the universe, right. So, yeah. If you did have a hiccup in some way, full moon, clear that out so that you've got the space to move forward. Because it's going to be better than it was before. Yay. Oh, yay. Let me know if you, like, start a channel or a group or something. I want to join. Okay. Right. What do the guardian angels want you guys to know for November. Oh, they're being specific, okay. What are the guardian angel messages for the Scorpio rises? Yes, no, okay. For November. Here we go. Any others, or is that it? Okay, I think that's it. Ooh! I'm gonna leave that one till the end. Okay, so we've got forgiveness. Well, we've got the full moon. Holding on to a past hurt is preventing you from moving forward and achieving your heart's desires, expansion and growth, community, alchemize. Let it go. Forgiveness does not mean that you condone another's actions. It simply means that you are no longer willing to be a perpetual victim to a particular person or event. Blame is a waste of your precious energy. Bless and surrender the past, for in doing so, you will reclaim the joy of life. Now, didn't we see something else that said something about the past? I thought we did. But anyway, thing is, that's not the most potent energy in this reading for you. That is. So clear away anything previously. I want to keep the self-love up, so it's still obvious. Because that's right in the middle too, see? Inner child, exactly. Self-love. Nurture your inner child. Remember, Cancer was the sign that covered your ninth. Nurture your inner child and begin to express the awesome beauty you hold within you. We live in a world where a formula exists for everything, yet love and creativity have no formula. They do not need to be studied, simply nurtured. Regularly set aside some time to just play. Yes, self-love. Set aside time to just play and be you. Be the animal, be the doula. Enjoy that process. Enjoy that energy, because that's going to help you as well with your ESP and, you know, expanding and growing your vision the way you want it to. Star. Believe in yourself. You are a wonder of creation. Wash away all fear and discover you are a shining star. Allow all around you to just be. Let go of trying to control life, for the light of your soul will guide you always towards love. Remember, stars are born through explosions of love. Love illuminates all things. Never forget, you are truly a shining star, creatorhood. If you have a platform and something seemed to be a bit stop, start, well, it's about to take off. It's about to take off. If you don't have a platform, start one, because it's about to take off. Self-love, make time to play, and then you can get into this and bring about your vision. I'm going to turn this around because you're going to bring about your vision. You know the drill. You've got the idea. Okay, so, hopefully this has made sense, and I wish you all the best of luck with it all. Bam, new moon, eclipse energy. You're going to eclipse your life in such an amazingly good way. On that note, I wish you all the best of luck with it all for November and onwards. And until next time, bye for now.